Have you ever wanted to turn your backyard into a gourmet smokehouse? If so, you're in the right place. Today, we're going to learn how to use the Masterbuilt Electric Smoker. In this video, you will learn how to use a Masterbuilt Electric Smoker for the first time, the best ways to put meat in the smoker, how to keep the temperature steady while smoking, plus, I'll answer some frequently asked questions along the way. So if you want to learn more about this amazing smoker, let's get started. In order to use a Masterbuilt Electric Smoker for the first time, we need to prepare the smoker. This step removes any leftover oils from the factory and creates a layer that stops rust, which leads us to how to season a Masterbuilt Electric Smoker. First, you will want to clean the inside with a damp cloth to remove dust, then make sure that the water pan is empty for now, then plug in your smoker and set it to 275 degrees Fahrenheit, and then let it cook for about 3 hours. After the first hour or two, fill the wood chip loader with dry wood chips like hickory, apple, or mesquite. Watch the smoker to make sure it's making smoke. After 3 hours, turn it off and let it cool down. Let's move on to how to start a Masterbuilt Electric Smoker for the first time. The next time you want to use the Masterbuilt Electric Smoker, you simply plug in the smoker, set your desired temperature using the digital control panel, fill the water pan, and add wood chips. Allow the smoker to come up to the desired smoking temperature. Now that your smoker is ready, it's time to put in the meat. Put delicate meats like fish or thin slices on the top rack. Put thicker, more robust meats like brisket or ribs either on the bottom rack or on the middle rack. If you're interested in how to smoke a whole chicken on the Masterbuilt Electric Smoker, stay tuned until the end of this video where I have a link to that video. A tip here is to let your meat warm up to room temperature before putting it in the smoker. This helps it cook evenly, but don't leave it out for more than an hour or two. Some additional things that I want to mention are, use a meat probe to keep tabs on the internal temperature of the meat. Put it in the thickest part away from any bones. Also, the water pan is important for keeping meat juicy. Fill it before you start smoking. You can add apple juice, beer, or herbs to the water for extra flavor. To keep meat moist, you can spray with a mix of apple juice, vinegar, or water every hour. As far as how to use a Masterbuilt Electric Smoker with wood chips, you will add a handful of dry wood chips to the chip loader every 30 to 45 minutes for consistent smoke production. The most important thing that you want to avoid is opening the door too much. This lets out heated smoke, which can change how long it takes to cook and how it tastes. Bonus tips! Wear gloves when handling the smoker to keep your hands clean and safe. Consider buying a cover to protect your smoker from the weather. The smoker has an adjustable timer. Set it for about 30 minutes after you expect your smoking session to finish. This way, you won't have to worry about overcooking your meat or having to remember to turn off the smoker. And obviously, always use the smoker outside where there's plenty of fresh air for safety. In regards to how to set the temperature on a Masterbuilt Electric Smoker, use the control panel to set your desired temperature. For most meats, a temperature between 225 and 250 degrees Fahrenheit works well. On most Masterbuilt Electric Smokers, the temperature range is anywhere from 100 to 275 degrees Fahrenheit. How often you should add wood chips to the Masterbuilt Electric Smoker? This question really depends on what is being smoked, but I would say that you should add a handful of wood chips every 30 to 45 minutes to keep the smoke steady. Here's a general guideline for how long different meats take to smoke. Ribs, approximately 5 to 6 hours. Large cuts, like pork shoulder or brisket, usually 10 to 12 hours. Whole chicken typically takes 2 to 3 hours. Fish generally takes 2 to 3 hours as well. Now keep in mind, these are just estimates. The best way to determine if your meat is done is to check its internal temperature, which should reach about 165 degrees Fahrenheit for most meats. Most Masterbuilt Electric Smokers come with a built-in meat probe. However, if yours doesn't, or if you need a more accurate probe, I highly recommend the Meter Plus meat probe, which you can find linked in the description. For optimal smoky flavor, focus on generating smoke during the first half to two-thirds of the cooking time, as the meat won't absorb much additional smoke after that point. To achieve great barbecue, it's important to maintain a steady temperature. If you notice the temperature is dropping, you may need to adjust the vents or cooking temp. You may even need to add more wood chips. Every time you smoke meat is a chance to try new things and find new flavors. What will you try smoking next? Let me know in the comments. For those hungry for more, check out the playlist at the end. It's packed with charcoal, grilling, and smoking recipes for everything from chicken and ribs to burgers and steaks. For even more jewelry recipes, head over to smokythebeginnings.com. I left a link in the description. And if you'd like to support the channel and fuel my caffeine addiction, you'll find a link for that below too. Until next time, keep those fires burning and those taste buds tingling. Have a good one.